Yaskawa. You are watching the IEC 61131 Basics series. In this video, we'll explain how to use the help system of MotionWorks IEC. Hi, I'm Matt Pelletier. At this point, I assume you've worked through the programming quick start tutorial videos, and so you have some experience with MotionWorks IEC. So the idea is that now, if you can learn how to use the different parts of the help system, you'll be able to help yourself as we move along with MotionWorks IEC and IEC 61131. So first, as an overview, we need to understand that IEC programming has various components, and so by nature, there is also a modular help system covering those different components. Each part of the software, therefore, has a separate help file for both flexibility and accuracy. And so I'd also point out that you can search for the CHM files. That's the extension of the files. If you would like to read all of those or have those collected for reference, we don't normally do that, but sometimes the help is requested in that fashion. And one thing that's interesting is to note that there's the country dialing code is appended to the file name, and that's one way to find the languages for English or Japanese, Chinese, or the other supported languages. So moving on to the programming interface, let's go locate the help here under the question mark menu, and you can see the different areas of help for the software. So this first one here called Contents, you can open this. This will bring you to the MotionWorks IEC Pro help. And you can expand this to see the different areas, such as IEC 61131 Basics. So if you would prefer to learn by reading the documentation, this is the place for you, IEC 61131 Basics. You can read more about data types and variables. And I'll be pointing out these different pieces at the appropriate times during this training tutorial series. So I'll close this help. Now let's go to the help about IEC 61131. You can see it really goes to the same help file called MotionWorks IEC Pro. It just goes to this folder, IEC 61131 Basics. So that's a shortcut for you. The third one down says help on standard FBFU. And you can tell that the title of this is a separate, it's a separate file. So this is the help for all of the different functions and function blocks associated with IEC 61131. Usually we'll use right-click help on the block to find the help for a specific instruction, but this is the full help for that. And then the final one, PLC help, is again a shortcut to the help file MotionWorks IEC Pro, the PLC help area, as opposed to IEC 61131 Basics. So this is all one file. There's really two files going on here. There's the file for the instructions, and then there's the file for how to use the programming system and the section on IEC 61131 Basics. And if you are interested in seeing these help files in a language other than English, you need to go to the menu item here next to the help called Extras, and you'll choose Options. And there are many tabs within the options. You want to go to the General tab and choose the language of your choice. You will need to restart the software. It'll tell you to restart the software in order to use this language. I'm going to leave mine on English. And as I mentioned, this red icon for the help on the instructions applies specifically to the IEC 61131 instructions, such as add, subtract, timer, or pulse. And this also applies, I maybe didn't say this directly, to the edit wizard groups called function blocks, functions, string functions, and type convert functions. All of the help is for these blocks and those groups of the edit wizard are located in this help on standard function and function block. And again, also available in several languages. Okay, so I promised I would show the right-click help. It's really straightforward. You right-click on a block either in the edit wizard or in the code. So let's take a minute here to look at that. And in this case, I'm in the type convert function still from the last video. Let's look at dword to byte. You can right click on it, show the help for the function block. And you can see it gives you the help, tells you what to do with the input and output parameter. Let's go to a more interesting one. In fact, why don't we open up the main POU and right click on the counter. You know, in the previous example, I just told you exactly what to put on there. And however, you could have figured it out yourself by looking at the help for that function block. And you'd see what each of the input and output parameters are for, which data type is expected, and a description of what they do. They'll even go so far as to give you an example. This is even where I got the idea for the parking garage. It's from this online help. And you can see that this right click is simply a shortcut to this help for functions and function blocks file to the exact location that tells you the help. Let's try a few more. Maybe the add block, right click, and help on that one. Okay. Maybe something interesting like RTrig, rising edge detection, right click, help. And this help, although labeled here by Yaskawa, is specific to IEC 61131. And so the help that we show here is the same help for all practical purposes that you would see in another manufacturer here for RTrig. And finally, I'd like to point out what we call the contextual help button. A lot of times you'll have a question about what does the download screen, what does all this mean? Well, there's a help button somewhere on here. If you can find that help button, many of your questions will be answered. It may bring up other questions, but in many of the areas that we've already used, you may have noticed a help button. And so if you're wondering what's the rest of the story, what does everything do, what are the buttons do in that area, click on the help, and that will bring you exactly to the area of the help file that explains what's going on with this particular function. Let me now talk through a simple example of how you might use the help in order to learn what you need to learn while you're programming. Let's say I'm looking through the edit wizard and I see there's, a timer, that'll be useful. And so I will right click on the timer and I see there's some help on the timer. I notice it pulled up the help on functions and function blocks. And I notice that there is an input parameter called PT, the preset time interval, and the data type is time. Now, that might be new to me with IEC, a data type called time. So I'll minimize that one and go to the help on IEC 61131. And within IEC 61131 basics, I see, okay, there are data types in IEC 61131 and elementary data types. I could look through this list here and see all of the IEC data types. And you notice that one of them is time. I can see also an example how this is done here, T pound 0s for the default initial value. And so I wonder if I could search for T pound and see more about what that means. Let's search. All right, T pound. And it says elementary data type. That's where I just was. Graphical editor, initializing variables. Comes up in sequential function chart. And it even comes up in this here literals. I can see here for numeric literals. Oh, there, okay, here it is. There's different ways to indicate time as a literal. A literal, remember, means a constant, not a variable, but a constant. And so there's different formats for using time. Anyway, all this you can find by just following the trail of help in order to learn what you need to learn in order to, in this case, I want to learn how to use a timer. We will go through learning how to use timers in a future video. Okay, let's close that. And also, I think that I should show the context-sensitive help. For example, we had been doing download using the project control dialog, and I had shown that there is a help button here. Let's click that help button, and you can see it brings us right up here to the control dialog resource, and it's going through here to tell us what the title bar, the state, stop, cold, warm, hot, restart, go, step, trace. If you want to know what all of these do, there is a detailed description, and you can see even links to more related help topics. And lastly, don't forget the old faithful F1 key for context-sensitive help. Even if you don't see a help button, it's worth hitting the F1 key in the active window, and that'll shoot you straight to the pertinent place in the software's help system. And so with this brief introduction, I think I will leave you to use the help from here on out to try to answer your questions, and I'll be promoting the use of the help system in the future videos as well. And we'll see you in the next video of Yaskawa's IEC 61131 Basics.